Hello students, today we will read chapter 6 of your history book, The Revolt of 1857. But first I give you introduction that how East India Company established themselves as the supreme political power in India, and then they made laws and policies which affect on different different people like kings, queens, peasants, landlords, etc. Then what was the impact of these policies and laws on the people? Students, by the mid-19th century, the British had established themselves as the supreme political power in India. A large part of India was under direct British administration, and other areas were under indirect British control, as the rulers of these areas acknowledged British supremacy. Nearly by 1957, India had completed 100 years of British rule. During this period, the Indians were unhappy and resented foreign rule, as the British were oppressive and exploitative. Means each and every Indian society were unhappy with these Britishers. The rulers resisted the annexation of their territories. Rulers नाराज थे क्योंकि उनके जो kingdom था उनके राज्यों को हत्याया जा रहा था. Noblemen नाराज थे क्योंकि उनकी ज़मींदारी उनसे छीन ली गई थी. किसान भी नाराज थे क्योंकि उन पर बहुत भारी tax लगाया गया था. The tribal people also feared a threat to their livelihood. The craftsmen also were against the new economic policies. Even the sepoys, जो सिपाही थे, जो कि कहा जाता था कि British Army की backbone है, वो भी उनसे unhappy थे क्योंकि ना तो उनका promotion उनको मिलता था और उन्हें treat भी properly नहीं किया जाता था. The different sections of society expressed their anger through protests and revolts. Between 1757 and 1857, there were numerous revolts in different parts of the country. But the biggest challenge to the British authority came in 1857. In this year, the people of India rose up against them. So students, the revolt began as a mutiny of the Indian soldiers on 10th May 1857 in the Meerut cantonment area. The mutiny means Kranti. So the mutiny soon spread to other parts of the country and became the first united effort by the people to exile the British from India. So let us study the grievances of the Indian people that united them in their struggle against foreign rule. Students, Nawabs and Rajas had started losing honor and authority since the mid 18th century. Lord Dalhousie was extremely ambitious and pro-imperialist, means samrajyavadi tha bahut jyada. According to his doctrine of lapse, if any ruler died without a natural born heir, his estate would lapse to the British. Means agar usne ek niti banayi thi jiska naam tha doctrine of lapse, उसके अकॉर्डिंग अगर कोई भी रूलर जिसका खुद का बच्चा नहीं है और वो जिसने और वो बिना किसी हायर के अपने उत्तराधिकारी के मर जाता है, तो उसका जो राज्य है वो ब्रिटिश राज्य में मिल जाएगा. दिस लेड टू द एनेक्सेशन ऑफ स्टेट्स लाइक झांसी, सतारा, नागपुर एटसेट्रा. स्टूडेंट्स, अवध वॉज द लास्ट टेरिटरी एनेक्स्ड बाय लॉर्ड डलहौजी. नवाब वाजिद अली शाह वॉज सेंट टू कैलकटा ऑन एनुअल पेंशन ऑफ 12 लाख रुपीज़. द कंपनी वॉन्टेड टू एंड द मुगल डायनेस्टी ऑल्सो. फॉर दिस अ प्रॉपर प्लान वॉज मेड एंड वॉज बींग इम्प्लीमेंटेड ग्रेजुअली. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द कंपनी रिमूव द नेम ऑफ मुगल किंग फ्रॉम कॉइन्स. An announcement was made in 1849 by Lord Dalhousie that the family of the Mughal emperor would be shifted out of the Red Fort after the death of Bahadur Shah Zafar. It was announced that they would be given some other place in Delhi as residence. Next topic is the peasants. Peasants means kisan and the sepoys. Students, at that time the peasants was suffered due to high revenue. Revenue means taxes, demands and the strict policy of its collection. The British took away a large part of his produce. जो भी वो produce करते थे, grow करते थे, वो उनसे बहुत बड़ी मात्रा में ले लिया जाता था. Most often the peasant and his family starved. और ज़्यादातर वो peasants और उसकी family भूखे रहते थे. Even when crops failed, he was forced to pay the land revenue. He often borrowed money from the money lender to pay it. And if he was unable to pay back the loan, the money lender took away his land. On the other hand, the Indian sepoys were also unhappy with their salary, allowance, and their service conditions. No Indian could rise above a post of Subedar. Indian soldiers were not given bhatta or foreign travel allowance. In those days, people feared to cross the sea as they believed they will lose their religion by crossing it. So in 1824, when they were asked to go to Burma by sea route, they simply rejected it. So for it, they were severely punished for it. सो इन 1856 द कंपनी पास्ड अ न्यू लॉ. कंपनी ने एक न्यू लॉ निकाला जिसके अकॉर्डिंग दैट एवरी न्यू पर्सन हु वांटेड टू बी एम्प्लॉयड बाय द आर्मी. जो भी पर्सन एम्प्लॉय चाहता है, नौकरी करना चाहता है आर्मी में, हैड टू एग्री टू सर्व ओवरसीज. उसे अपनी सर्विसेज देने के लिए समुद्र के पार जाना ही होगा. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज रिस्पॉन्सेज टू ब्रिटिश रिफॉर्म्स. Students, the British, in their attempt to civilize the backward people ko civilize karne ke liye, they introduced a number of reforms which the Indians felt was an undue interference on their customs and traditions. Indians ne socha ki wo unke customs aur traditions ke saath खिलवाड़ कर रहे हैं, उसके अंदर दखल अंदाजी कर रहे हैं. सम ऑफ दीज रिफॉर्म्स वर एबॉलिशन ऑफ सती, रीमैरिज ऑफ विडोज, इंग्लिश एज अ मीडियम ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन, इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ रेलवेज. लॉ पास्ड इन 1850 अलाउड कन्वर्ट्स टू क्रिश्चियनिटी टू इनहेरिट प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ देयर एंसेस्टर्स. Next point is from mutiny to rebellion. Students, the introduction of the Enfield rifles in 1857 served as the trigger for the revolt. It was rumored that the cartridges for these rifles were covered with a layer of grease made of animal fat. The cartridges had to be bitten off before being loaded. This went against the religious sentiments of both Hindus and as well as Muslims. The rumor spread like wildfire. Indian soldiers refused to use the Enfield rifles and the cartridges. On 29th March 1857, Mangal Pandey, a sepoy of the 34th Bengal Native Infantry at Barakpur, in Bengal, rebelled and refused to use the Enfield rifle. Though he was executed, it led to the revolt in other places, which culminated in the great uprising at Meerut. So students, it's all for today. Just read this chapter very carefully. टिल देन गुड बाय।